thank you for joining us this morning from Inniskillen and pray that you may know the love and peace of Christ.
Morning service came from St. McCartan's Cathedral in Elskill. The preacher was Reverend Alex Bennett, and the service was led by the Dean of Clogher, the very Reverend Kenneth Hall. The organist was Matthew Murphy, and the choir was conducted by James Hazlitt. And at 12 o'clock, you can hear the story of an Elskill Fusilier, Willie McBride, in The Green Fields of France. Next week, morning service will come from the Keswick at Porchurch. Morning service is a Blackthorn production for BBC Radio Ulster.
They might be well known for their songs.
If I could.
But how much do you actually know about some of the most popular names in the local country music scene?
I'd be sitting in the corner. Listen to these ghost stories, they'll hear me standing around you.
Well, I'm Hugo Duncan, and in a new series of country legends, I go behind the names and the songs to meet the people.
Stop the world and let me off.
Beginning with Declan Ernie, the wee man from Dumbish.
I wasn't that fierce interested in school. I couldn't even copy it right.
That's country legends. Saturday morning at 10:30, and afterwards at bbc.co.uk/radio-ulster.
Oh, that's it. Can I say it?
On 92 to 95 FM
and 1341 medium wave,
this is BBC Radio Ulster.
BBC News at 11 o'clock. I'm Anne-Marie Foster. At least 79 people have been killed in two bomb attacks in the Iraqi capital Baghdad. More than 100 were wounded. Hugh Sykes reports from Baghdad.
It was a huge bomb, probably a suicide car bomb. It exploded close to a restaurant. It happened soon after midnight in Karada, a central Baghdad neighbourhood where Sunni and Shia Muslims and Christians live and shop. The street was thronged with people buying refreshment drinks in the hot night and shopping for food for Ramadan meals. Several shops were destroyed and three-story buildings were severely damaged up to their roofs. This was almost certainly revenge by the self-styled unrecognized Islamic State for the liberation of Fallujah.
The Home Secretary Theresa May has insisted there must be a contest to decide the next Conservative leader and Prime Minister.